ladies and gentlemen, and you're all very, very welcome here tonight. I would just ask our six chairs will be processing in from either side, if you could keep both entrances clear. Okay, so my name is Mary Revlin. I'm the chaplain here in Gorey Community School, and it gives me immense pleasure to say, ladies and gentlemen, please rise to greet Gorey Community School's graduating class of 2023. And just a reminder, all choir members should be over here, or soloists. Okay. ladies and gentlemen. So just to check, all choir members should be over here for Miss Dempsey and Miss Clancy, okay? So you're all very welcome here to Gorey Community School celebration of the graduation class of 2023. This celebration tonight is a time to gather in gratitude to family, friends, school management, staff members and the extended school community. It is a time to thank God for the years that our sixth-year students spent in this school. The celebration tonight is also being streamed, so we want to send out greetings to anyone who's watching online. And if it does get too packed in here and it's too hot, it is also being streamed in the junior canteen, okay, which is just down the corridor. Tonight is also a time to look forward in confidence and hope, a time to give out our blessing and best wishes to the class of 2023 and send them out to the next exciting phase of their life.
Good evening, everybody. I know when people ask me about where I work and I tell them the size of the school, you know, most people are usually a little bit shocked by it. And I always tell them that I absolutely love working in such a big school, the biggest school in the country. But right now, just looking around me, I'm kind of having second thoughts. But anyway, it's absolutely lovely, absolutely wonderful to see so many people here. You're very, very welcome. It's great to see such a good turnout, wonderful support for our students, and it's just a lovely occasion. This is, and I said this to the students earlier in the week, this is my favourite week of the year, the awards week that ends off with the graduation service. This would be probably my favourite night of the school year. and you're all my favourite people, so what can be better than that? One of the many things that I love about our school is, once again, it's all down to the size of the school. It's so big, I really feel there's something for everyone. I remember a number of years ago, God, it must be about 10 years ago, when Gorey College was opening, and there was a parent in from with a child to our open night, and they were from a fairly small rural primary school, and the child was looking here, was looking in Gorey, and was looking in Kilmuckridge. And in the end, the mother sent in an application to us, and the reason she gave was that when the child saw all the three schools, she maintains that, well, Gorey Community School is so big that there'll probably be somebody odd like her, like me, in the school, and she was sure to make friends. The same student had her own unique individual talents, was very artistic, and did indeed, over the years, develop her own little crew. And that's what I love about the school. There's something and someone for everyone. One of the lovely things is there's just so many opportunities here to get involved. No matter what kind of academic ability you have, no matter what kind of hobbies, interests, sporting, the arts, there's an opportunity to get involved. And that's always so important. And I can see you. I saw this on Tuesday when all of you sixth-year students were at the award service, the award ceremony. I just saw, with the array of certs, medals, trophies that were being presented, you could just see how you, as a year group over the years, really embraced the opportunities and really got the most and got as much as you could out of the school. And I think that's hugely commendable. You really took the chance and took the opportunity to make great friends and to make great memories. It's all about size tonight, isn't it? But another thing about that I love about working in such a large school is that our school, just given the fact that there's 1,627 students and about 160 staff, it's a really noisy, and I mean noise in a very positive way, a noisy, vibrant, energetic, and I feel happy environment. Tomorrow, with you guys graduating tonight, tomorrow I'm conscious that some of that vibrancy, some of that sound, some of that happiness will be gone. I really feel that although physically you're going, I'm very conscious that you as a year group have left your mark. To me, your mark, and this is something I said to you in your award ceremony, to me, your mark is the whole spirit of friendship and generosity and kindness towards each other that I have seen in your award ceremonies, but that I see on a daily basis when you're interacting with each other and other groups around the school. And to me, that's priceless, and it's a wonderful legacy. When I look at you guys tonight as well, I see potential. I see the future nurses, teachers, future electricians, doctors, hairdressers, accountants. They're all wonderful professions, and they're services that we all use every day. Okay, I probably don't go into the hairdressers too often, but the rest of them, I certainly do. And I know that you all have goals. You all have ambitions that you're striving for. You all have particular points, particular grades you're looking to get. And I would just encourage you, because you can do anything. You could, if you believe hard enough, you can really, the world is really your oyster. You can go and achieve anything. And I'd encourage you to continue to strive for your goal and for your ambition. Another person who is graduating tonight or in the next couple of months and also beginning a new chapter is our Deputy Principal, Ms. Kyo. And you can see, I just saw tonight, the wonderful Time magazine poster, you'll probably see it at some point tonight, of Miss Kyo's face as well, and it's lovely. And I'm just going to say a couple of small things about Miss Kyo. Miss Kyo has been deputy principal in Gorey Community School for the last 25 years, which is an incredible amount of time. That's out of a teaching career of 40 years. It's phenomenal. 40 years. 2 points I'm going to say about Miss Kyo. And the first one, I don't say lightly. Miss Kyo is part of the fabric of Gorey Community School. And that's not something you can say about many people, but it's definitely true of Stella Keogh. Stella is part of the spirit, part of the soul of Gorey Community School. The smile, the no-nonsense approach, the work, the support for students and for staff is unbelievable. The second point is in relation to you. Ms. Keogh believed and believes that school is primarily about the students, and that everything that Ms. Keogh does and has done over her time as teacher, as deputy principal, has been to support the students and to help them achieve their potential. From a professional point of view, but especially from a personal point of view, we're going to miss a wonderful colleague and an amazing friend. I think I'd like everyone to give Ms. Keogh a round of applause. To the parents who are here tonight, it's lovely to see so many parents, family members, extended family members. Really, really important. And, you know, it's 5, in most cases, 6 years ago since I met you all here in the gym as we were getting ready for your sons and daughters to start. And at that particular stage, your sons and daughters were just finishing sixth class. They were graduating from primary school. And you as parents, and certainly your sons and daughters, were a bit nervous, were a bit unsure, and a bit almost traumatised about the prospect of starting in secondary school. And yet, it's been, I feel, an outstanding success. The support that the parents have given us over the years, and ultimately given to your sons and daughters, has really produced this result we see in front of us today, of fine, upstanding young men and women. I know in my interactions with the parents, we didn't all see eye to eye in every single conversation. We didn't always agree all the time, but I do hope that we always came to an understanding. And I do know that our communications were always respectful, and ultimately, all of us were working for the benefit of our students. So, as parents, you certainly have my gratitude and my thanks. A final word of thanks, and I wrote down a little post-it because I was really frightened that I was going to forget it in the kind of excitement of the night. The quad looks lovely, the gym looks beautiful, and that didn't just happen. A good team of staff were there in the quad. A couple of people, I have to mention Miss Kenny's name in particular, literally, physically, putting me to shame as she was out there with the power washer, power washing away. So a huge amount of work has gone into it, and it's gone into it simply to make the event, to give it the specialness, to give it the importance that an event like this deserves. Your graduation from secondary school, your preparation to kind of proceed to the next stage of your lives, it's important. So therefore, the effort needs to be put in. The Parents Association have been busy as well, and they're hoping that after the ceremony, and it's such a lovely evening, it'll be a really nice thing to do, that as the parents and guardians here tonight won't rush off, and hopefully you'll stay and mix and have some refreshments. I'm going to conclude now. I want to congratulate you on graduating. You're an outstanding year group. Not over yet. You have a few weeks ahead of you, and we are, as always, right up to the time you put your pen down in your last exam. We're here to help you and support you in any way we can. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Finn. And as today we gather to remember and to give thanks, we are aware of the stories that shaped our lives and brought us to this moment. We are mindful that as we come to the end of one journey, we are about to begin another. And so we come in gratitude for all that has been and welcome the gift of what will be. Above all, we acknowledge God's presence in ourselves, each other, and the world around us. Walk with us, Lord, as we move from this place into a future filled with your love and peace. Fill your children with love and peace, especially this graduating class of 2023. And now we're going to have the presentation of the gifts. So can I ask the following students to come forward? Aaron Leonard, Kaylee Redmond-Tompkins, Joe Kinsler, Tia Gann, Jenna Kenny, Shane Kelly, Tiernan Black, and Keen Waters.
Kaylee is presenting the school tie and school journal. The tie represents the uniform of our school that we have been proud to belong to for the past 5 or 6 years. The journal represents the many rules we followed, which have allowed us to gain great education and achieve our potential. Joe is presenting a musical instrument. This represents all the music talent of the school and the joy that we have gained from music and the arts in our lives. We remember with gratitude the work of students and teachers have done together and helped to celebrate all the special events in our school lives. Morgan is presenting a trophy. This represents the successes. Shane is presenting a trophy. This represents all the successes that we have had in sport and cultural events during our 5 or 6 years here in Gorey Community School. It also represents the efforts made by many students that did not result in a trophy or a cup, but where the students put all their effort into what they did. We acknowledge their efforts and realise that sometimes in life we do not gain a tangible reward for what we do. It reminds us of the support and friendship that we've been lucky to have had for over the past 5 or 6 years. This support has seen us through the difficulties which we've faced and allowed us to emerge stronger and more resilient. Tia is presenting the Tree of Life. The tree has deep roots and wide branches. This represents each person's personal development, uniqueness and individual beauty. Just as the branches of the tree strengthen and grow upwards towards the sky, so too do we grow stronger, striving for greater knowledge, wisdom and experiences as we move throughout life. It also represents the friendships made and a hope for the future. Jenna is presenting a rainbow. When we move, the rainbow moves with us. We see a different reflection of the sun made by different raindrops as we move. Somebody standing next to us will see the colours differently because they see a slightly different reflection. So, if you see a certain situation differently to a friend, don't argue as to who is right. Think of the rainbow instead and you may find you both are right. But just see the colours in a different way. Tiernan and Killian are presenting the photograph and a candle in memory of our friend and classmate Colin Donnelly. Shine your light just as Colin did. Live life to the full as Colin did. Remember that life is always has purpose and meaning. Now we invite Mark Hinch and Ben Rothwell to come forward.
We would like to say a few words about our friend Colin. For us, Colin was a larger than life person and a great friend. This always helped us if you were going out in Gorey, as he had made great friends with all the bouncers in the town. So always you were guaranteed entry into every bar, sometimes, but that you were always safe when you were out with him. I was lucky enough to play rugby with Colin. Myself and Colin were a sight to behold when we togged out. We were asked by Mr. McCarthy when Colin died what position he played. We quickly answered, anywhere where he could break lads up. I was struck at Colin's funeral how well he was known, not just from school and the rugby club, but the whole area. And we all felt the same about him. This larger-than-life friend that I was so lucky to know was a huge loss to our year, but I'm so glad to have known him. Thank you.
I've known Colin for a very long time, mostly because our fathers were into the same thing in farming and machinery. We loved working and loved the crack, and you were guaranteed he'd always get up to a prank or two. Even when we were 11 or 12 and we were going back to the yard to get dinner and Colm dropped a lump of silage onto a brand new car and dropped it onto the windscreen, causing it to swerve, and our fathers weren't too pleased now when we tried, when we did that. But there was no greater pleasure for me than being out working with Colm, and as these bright sunny days appear, I know exactly where the two of us would have been, driving tractors and looking forward to a crisp sandwich, and probably no thought for the leaving, or yeah, definitely no thought for leaving. Shane Kelly has been with Colm all through primary and secondary school. He was a towering figure, even in fourth class. They were never let sit together until the last day of sixth class, when the teacher finally said they could. They lasted till break time before they had to be separated. We just want to remember our friend, and as others have said, it is hard to lose a friend, but we can all count ourselves lucky that we knew Colm. Colm Donnelly, forever 18.
Passes a sun like a
Now I'd like to invite forward Ava Callaghan and Remy Lalloy, our Students of the Year for 2023.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the graduation ceremony for the Gorey Community School Class of 2023. My name is Remy, this is Ava, and we are at once both humbled and honoured to be given the opportunity on behalf of the six-year students to address you all here tonight. We would like to extend a particular welcome to the Board of Management representatives, Mr. O'Toole and Ms. Moran, to Father Roger O'Neill, Conan Mark Hayden and Rosemary Lacey. We would then like to express our gratitude to so many people who have played such a key role in bringing us to this moment in time. Thank you, Mr. Finn, for your tireless commitment over the past 6 years. Your Trojan work does not go unnoticed. Thank you to Ms. Martin and the Yearhead team, Ms. O'Mahony, Mr. Gann, Ms. Keegan, for watching over us and relentlessly hunting us down when we missed classes, forgot notes, misplaced ties, or whatever it was we were doing wrong on any given day. Thank you, Ms. Keogh, Mr. McCarthy, Ms. McAvoy, for ensuring the seemingly effortless and smooth running of everyday life here in GCS. You have managed our time here at GCS, allowing us to make our days here not only enjoyable, but more importantly, memorable. We cannot let also the evening pass without acknowledging you, Ms. Keogh, for your imminent retirement. Your legacy is entrenched within the spirit of Gorey Community School, and it will not be the same place without you. Thank you also to Ms. Neary, Ms. Connaughton, Ms. O'Neill, and Ms. Atkinson for your continuous guidance, advice, and for all the career opportunities you have provided us with over the last 2 years. Thank you, our teachers, who have always gone above and beyond to encourage, support, and provide us with the educational expertise required to get us to this level of achievement. And a special thank you goes to Miss O'Reilly for helping us write our speech. And finally, we would like to thank you, our parents, the unsung heroes of our lives. Without you, where would we be? You have been here through it all. You have not only nurtured us, but loved us, grounded us, worked hard for us, and picked up after us. To say you have helped us reach where we are today would be an understatement. You are the people we aspire to be. And on a more personal note, I want to thank you, my fellow classmates, for welcoming me into your year despite my late arrival in fifth year. The 2 years I have spent with you have been the best of my school life, and there is nobody I would rather stand alongside today, nobody I would rather face the Leaving Cert with, nobody I would rather go out with tonight, and nobody I would rather call my friends than all of you. And as our time spent together in GCS draws to a close, I know we'll not only miss the people around us that we love, but we'll also miss the people we are now, at this time, because we'll never be this way ever again. Never again will we all be sitting in this hall together. Never again will we hear a memorable Mr. Finn speech or a Miss Redmond prayer. Never again will we gather for break, race to the car, share a lunch, or even walk together to class, undertaking complex yet frivolous routes. Never again will we wait at our lockers as our successors take an unnecessary amount of time, and never again will we have uniform checks, late notes, or even intercom announcements. But life is comprised of a plethora of moments, some sad, some happy, some important, some insignificant, some exciting, and some dull. And as I stand before you, trying to seize this precise moment, I realise that I cannot. So we should endeavour not to capture moments with snapshot pictures or even thoughts, but rather we should endeavour to live them and to truly be present here right now, because though it will continue to shine like gold in my memories, Nothing will bring back this moment in time. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you, Remy, for acknowledging all of the great people who have helped us to get to this moment in time. Don't worry, I won't keep you here too long, as I know there are many places us innocent students want to get to visit tonight, but I do want to say a few things before I go. To anybody else, it might seem that the narrative is circular, that we're right back at the place where we began, but to anybody in the know, quite the opposite is true. Look at us now. Who knew we'd grow into this group of sophisticated, good-looking, enthusiastic, high-achieving and considerate students sitting here today? Time is not measured by clocks, but by moments. It only seems like moments ago that we were first years, sitting exactly where we are now. Hearing each other's first names for the first time, meeting all the other frightened fresh faces, while our parents panicked in the background, filling out forms, taking photos left, right and centre, and making all sorts of promises about what a wonderful contribute it would be to the school. Back then, parents were scared. Didn't know if we'd make friends, they didn't know if they organised or colour-coded our lockers in the right way, and they didn't know if we had chosen the right subjects for ourselves. Our parents may still worry about us now. They may be still taking photos, still telling us to smile a certain way, stand smartly, not to mess anywhere. They were scared to see us grow, but now they're willing to see us flourish. As I look around tonight, I realise how a funny story or inside joke comes to mind for every single one of you. This is a testament to how diverse and yet closely knit we've come to be over time. Without a doubt, I have seen many aspects of our school community during my 6 years here. It still blows my mind how students who spend hours training outside for sports such as camogie or soccer can mix so well with students who spend hours inside drawing, reading, playing music, practicing instruments, or tackling something like chemistry or maths, which will never be fully comprehended in my brain, no matter how hard Mr. Sunderland tries. There have been many times that my twin brother Ryan has spoken endlessly about his projects in DCG, construction, engineering, and I have had absolutely no notion as to what you're on about. I'm sorry, Ryan. But it's his enthusiasm he shows that keeps me listening to him every time. The only time I can remember, I think, switching off from him was when he started investigating his options for anything but a bag day. You wouldn't believe the shock I got the next morning when I found him wearing a basketball hoop at the front door. It hasn't always been easy, and we remember the struggles people have had and are currently dealing with still. We remember those we have lost, who sadly cannot be with us tonight. We remember our classmate Colm Donnelly and his family. He will not be forgotten, and we hope you know you have our continuous support. Time is a strange thing. It deludes and confounds us. I remember climbing Tower Hill and Fort Mountain. I remember laser tag and bowling, archery on the back pitches. COVID didn't give us a lot, but the teachers sure did give us what they could. And I would like to take this opportunity as well to mention the other staff members who have recently announced their retirement. To Ms. Lenihan, Ms. Yagwe, Mr. Doyle, Mr. McCormack, Ms. Fitzpatrick, we thank you and we wish you health and happiness. To the class of 2023, together we became friends. Together we sat on benches and together we went on school trips and had lunchtime adventures. To my girls and my boys at the benches, to Sophie for sticking by my side, to my teachers and guidance counsellors who stayed with me in my endless questions, I want to say thank you. To my encouraging family, especially my mum and dad, for getting me this far and helping me to stand by my decisions. There's tissues in my gear bag. I love you and I thank you. And to my fellow students, for giving me this moment in time. I cannot thank you enough. Remember, try not to cry because it's over, but smile because life has just begun. Thank you.
Well done, Ava and Remy. Okay, our Students of the Year 2023. So I'll invite Morgan Hargreaves to come forward.
No matter what you're going through, there's a light at the end of the tunnel. And it may seem hard to get to it, but you can do it. And just keep working towards it and you'll find the positive side of things. In this reading, St. Matthew encourages us to be a light for each other. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. You are the light of the world. A city on top of a hill can't be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a basket. Instead, they put it on top of a lampstand, and it shines on all who are in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before you, so they can see the good things you do and praise your Father who is in heaven. This is the gospel of the Lord.
So for our intercessional prayers, I'd like to invite Shane Bellidi, Mia Davey, Ava Whelan, Niall Sheehan, Evan Harper and Leah Cecil forward, please.
Lord, we pray for our parents and we thank you for the support that they have given throughout our lives. We hope that they know how much we appreciate them, although sometimes we might have difficulty showing it. We pray they know how important they are to us. Lord, hear us. Lord, we pray for the staff of Gorey Community School. We would like to thank them for their guidance and support throughout these memorable years. We thank you especially for the efforts that you made during COVID times to help us get through and ensure that we did not miss out on too much schooling. We also pray for the students who will continue on in our school. May they be happy in everything they do and always have hope in their future. Lord, hear us.
Lord, as we leave the stage of our lives, may we always keep the light of hope in our hearts. With each new day that comes and every step that we take, may we always remember the true essence of the human spirit. That is hope. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Tonight, Lord, we think of all the friends we have made during our years in Gorey Community School. We remember our laughter and our tears. As we reach the stage of our life's journey, may we continue to be blessed with good friends. May we always carry with us the good memories of the friends we have made here in this school. Lord, hear us.
Lord, tonight we remember all the places in the world where peace does not prevail, where young people like us do not have the opportunity to go to school in peace. We ask you to help world leaders and governments to make decisions for peace and equality. Lord, hear us.
As we reach this crossroads, may we be guided and helped to choose the right road and to make the best of the gifts we have been given. Guide us to remain true to ourselves as we step tentatively into the future. Lord, hear us.
There are people, Lord, who have passed away who we would have loved to share this special evening with us. Our lives are better for having known them, and we are grateful for their presence in our lives. We pray that they may know how much they are loved and missed. Lord, keep all our departed loved ones in your loving care. We remember in a special way our classmate Colm Donnelly, who passed away tragically in February. Lord, hear us.
Thank you.
Well, now we have the ceremony of light. I'm going to invite sixth-year student Ava Hardy, teacher Ms. Caroline Kennedy, parent Ms. O'Donnell Kenny, board of management member Ms. Kate Moore, and first-year students Cuiva Byrne and Katie Kinsella to come forward, please. Tonight we bring together the young and the not so young. Every generation is more advanced than the last, and that is as it should be. The young know all about change, the older know about what does not change. In the ceremony of light, we pass on the gifts of wisdom, love, faith, and memory.
Thanks. This evening marks a special time for us sixth-year students in Gorey Community School. It is an ending, but it is also a beginning. We have spent 5 or 6 years in this school, working and dreaming, playing sport and making friends. It is time for us to begin the next exciting phase of our lives. Although we are sad to leave the school, which has been our home and sanctuary for the past 6 years, we are excited to begin this new phase. We offer this light for ourselves and for all the other students who are in our school. We remember all, also at this time, all the people and the places in the world where there is war. We pray that the light of hope will continue to shine for them in those troubled times.
On behalf of the staff of the school, I offer you the light of wisdom. Carry this light from this place to a world that stands in need of wisdom. A world that faces decisions and choices never dreamed of in times past. Remember that everything you learned in school was learned in the company of others. Be open to the learning that is ahead of you. May you be a light of wisdom for others. May you grow in a wisdom that will inspire you to find the good and the true. May this light of wisdom guide you during your exams and in your future life on the road ahead.
On behalf of all the parents gathered here this evening, I offer you the light of love. This is a light we lit for you a long time ago. It is a light you depend on in those early days. The light that you ran to when things went wrong, the light that was left on for you because you were afraid of the dark. This is the light that waited up for you if you were home late, and the light that was always there, even though sometimes, just sometimes, you wished it wasn't. Carry this light of love into a world where real love is rare and precious. Use it to light the path of your own search to love and be loved. And when you find that light is flickering, blown about by troubles of life, remember that there will always be a light burning for you in that place called home.
On behalf of the trustees and management of this school, I offer you the light of faith. Within all of us is a light. It is fed by joy and strengthened by faith. It sustains us through difficult times. Over the years, its flame has been fueled by the example of those around you. Now, you must carry that light for yourself. You will not find it an easy task. There may be a price to pay. The flame will flicker. It may even be extinguished for a time. But the most important thing about the flame of faith is that it is not yours alone. A lone flame cannot pierce the darkness, but many flames together can cast a great light. May you be a source of light for all you will meet on your life journey.
On behalf of all the students that you leave behind, we offer you the light of memory. When you are in sixth year, you say that the first years are very young and very, very small. But when you are in first year, as we are, you sixth-year students seem very old and very big. 5 or 6 years ago seems a very long time. We will leave school in the year 2028. Where will you be then? Days pass by, and for you now, school days are over.
Carry the light of those with you. When you meet, tell again the stories of those years in the classroom and on the playing field. Remember the victories and the disappointments, the lost locker key, the exam success, the sporting achievements, and perhaps the cooling off time outside the principal's office. We ask you to remember us, who will continue the story of the school to the end of the year 2028 and beyond. Remember us, we will remember you.
Now I'd like to invite forward Alice Kovalchuk and Aaron McKevitt to read a reflection, and they are accompanied by Oisin MacConnamar on the violin.
Let nothing hold you back from exploring your biggest dreams, wishes, and aspirations.
Don't be afraid to dream big and to follow your dreams wherever they may lead you. Open your eyes to their beauty, open your mind to their magic, open your heart to their possibilities. Dare to dream. Whether they are in colour or in black and white, whether they are big or small, easily attainable or almost impossible, I look to you to dream and make them become reality.
Wishes and hopes are nothing until you take the first step towards making them something. Dare to dream, because only by dreaming will you ever discover who you are, what you want, and what you can do. Don't be afraid to take risks, to become involved, to make a commitment. Do whatever it takes to make your dreams come true. Always believe in miracles and always believe in you.
Welcome to Father Rogers, members of the Board of Management, Parents Council, management, teachers, parents and guardians and families, and especially to Gorey Community School graduates of 2023. I will just begin by thanking a few people. Mr. Finn, I have had the pleasure of working alongside over the past 6 years. I have witnessed his integrity, courage, kindness, loyalty and respect in dealing with people. You know what to expect and what is expected. He's especially tough on students, as he leads by example and expects the very best out of the students of Gorey Community School. I thank him on behalf of the Earhead team for his unwavering support to us and this year group. I would like to thank the Earhead team, Kevin Gann, Laura Keegan, Eleanor Manny and Kira Walsh, who have been a pleasure to work with. Thank you to your teachers over the years. They say that children have never been good at listening to adults, but they never fail to imitate them. Luckily, we have good role models in Gorey Community School. The SEN department, David Byrne, Sharon Freeney, all the special needs assistants, the school chaplain, Mary Redmond, who organised this evening's celebration, Damien Marshall, the homeschool liaison officer, they've all been with you over the past 6 years. Their work and dedication are greatly appreciated. Thank you to the career guidance teachers, Karina Atkinson, Caroline O'Neill, Aidan Connaughton, and especially Davinet Neary, who was your guidance counsellor for the first 3 years. They were always there on hand to listen, guide, and support you. Thank you to Roisin Dempsey and Sarah Clancy and their sixth-year music class for providing the beautiful music this evening. Thank you to Eileen Tomalty and Mark Bolton-Lee for organising the decoration for the gym during the week for the awards. And tonight, Roisin Dempsey, Teresa Kenny, Davinet Neary and Kate Moran and Mark Bolton-Lee for the quad and getting it organised this evening. It wasn't too difficult to decorate the gym, as all they needed was the beautiful faces of this year's graduates behind me. Thank you to all the staff who voluntarily given their time to coach you, prepare you for your orals, art portfolios, school musicals, business enterprise, maths and science quizzes, student council, Benemerente over the years. To the office staff, cleaning staff, caretakers who work tirelessly behind the scenes, Liz and Denise do an excellent job at reception. No task is too great for them, always helpful and obliging to the Earhead team, parents and students. Thank you to Ms. McAvoy and Mr. McCarthy and your former Deputy Principal, Mr. Duke, for their support of the students over the year. I would like to mention a special lady, she's been mentioned already. You'd hear her before you'd see her on the corridors of Gorey Community School for 30 years and has finally decided to hang up her heels and venture into another exciting time of her life. Deputy Principal Stella Keogh has been a very good friend and mentor to me over the years. She has been a stalwart advocate of the values of Gorey Community School: care, respect, inclusion, equality, fairness and community, and embodied these in her dealings with students and staff. On behalf of the Earhead team and the graduating class of 2023, we would like to wish Ms. Stella Courtney Keogh a happy, healthy, long retirement. The GCS halls will be much quieter without her. It's nearly over, and it's all about to begin. Tonight, surrounded by your family, friends, and the school community, you have reached one of the major milestones of your lives, your Leaving Certificate graduation ceremony. This is a major step in life's journey, and now you can understand the value of hard work, dedication, and commitment. That hard work and perseverance are essential to achieving your goals and realising your dreams. Well done. You should be very proud of yourselves, as we are of you. Any transition in life brings with it a mixture of excitement, trepidation, and I know many of you are nervous about taking your next step. But take it knowing that during the last 6 years in Gorey Community School, you've been provided with many opportunities and experiences that have given you time to develop as a person. From the shy, timid 12 to 13-year-olds I knew in first year, although some of you weren't that shy, to a more mature, confident, wiser, older 18, 19-year-old. As I mentioned at your awards this year, this group has taken full advantage of all that Gorey Community School has to offer. The years have been marked by incredible sporting achievements, impressive musical performances, excellence in arts, maths, science, and languages. Your students of the year, Ava and Remy, represent the qualities of this formidable year group. Hardworking, talented, friendly, dependable, trustworthy, and courageous. No doubt you have sketched out an imaginary map of the road you will follow. The road will not be smooth, and you will encounter many challenges that will test your strength, your courage, and your resilience. Difficulties are meant to rouse you, not discourage you. They give us time to reflect. Part of the challenge of life is turning obstacles into opportunities, stumbling blocks into stepping stones, and dead ends into doorways. Believe in yourselves as you take your next step in your own individual way, and continue to develop the considerable talents and gifts for the enrichment of your own lives and the betterment of your community. The friendships you have forged in your time here will stay with you long after you leave Gorey Community School. Watch out for good friends along the way. They're hard to find. A true friend accepts who you are, but also helps you become who you should be. Class of 2023, you have been a consistently pleasant presence in Gorey Community School. In the coming weeks, remember the importance of routine, rest, exercise, and a healthy diet. You've been training hard for your marathon. Now you just need to put one foot in front of the other and run it. The finishing line is in sight. Parents and guardians, for some of you, it's the first time your child has reached this stage of life. And for others, in the words of Hank Williams' song, "I've been down this road before, and it doesn't get any easier." You don't have to sit the Leaving Cert, but you certainly have gone through the highs and lows in their preparation for it. Continue to be there to support them over the next few weeks, on hand with a cup of tea, shoulder to cry on, and a listening ear for them to vent. I want to take this opportunity to thank you, the parents and guardians, for your continued support over the last 6 years. This support serves as an educational ally for teachers and management in developing students' full potential, where we have a safe, positive learning environment for all our students. This partnership has been vital and continues to be in maintaining this culture in Gorey Community School. Some of you have faced incredible challenges over the 6 years, and we all as a school community and wider Gorey Community School were struck to the core of our beings at the untimely passing of Colm Donnelly. His untimely passing is a stark reminder of just how fragile life can be. We often take our time on this earth for granted, assuming that we have all the time in the world to pursue our dreams and make a difference. The truth is, life is short. Live each day to its fullest with gratitude, as Colm did. We all arrive at different roads at the appropriate place. Each one has their star to follow and their path to trace. It's not the pace that matters as we go upon our way. It's what we really are when we get home at the close of the day. To the graduating class of 2023, from everyone here in Gorey Community School, we wish all of you success in life in the form of happiness, fulfillment,
and contentment, now and into the future. Go Nairi and Borhaliv, and thank you all so much.
Thank you, Ms. Martin. And now I'd like to invite Father Roger O'Neill up to give a final blessing.
This evening is a wonderful celebration of these young people before us, but indeed of the entire school community. So I thank Mr. Finn and Ms. Redmond for asking me here this evening. 30 years ago, when I was your age, and I did my leaving cert in the Tech in Wexford, we didn't have anything like this. And that was to, I suppose, really looking back on it, our loss. This is a wonderful thing to be doing, to be celebrating you and celebrating the school. But of course, you've picked the theme of time, moments. There's a Latin phrase, tempus fugit, time flies. And indeed it does. And it seems to go quicker the older you get, strangely enough. 32 years ago, in school in Wexford, a classmate and a very close friend of mine passed from this world very suddenly as well. And I can assure you that I know that, having experienced this yourselves with the loss of your classmate Colm, that the memory and the memories you have, they won't fade away as the time flies. There's a group of us as closest friends who still meet regularly, and we still cherish the memory and remember our friend who passed away back then. And I know, and I'm sure, it will be the same for ye. So let us remember and pray for Colm. Eternal rest granted him, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace, amen. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace, amen. And we pray for God's blessing. As we journey, as one journey ends, we begin another. Let us go forth into the world as people of faith, hope and vision. Hold fast to that which is good, and render to no one any harm. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak and the vulnerable. Help the afflicted. Give dignity and respect to all. Love and serve the Lord Jesus. Rejoice in the power and guidance of the Holy Spirit. Bless this class of 2023. Bless their parents and guardians. We ask this as we always do. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Okay, thank you for everybody. And just before we conclude, I just, as a few thanks I want to give to people. I asked Ms. Martin to thank most of the people on my behalf. So there's just a couple of people here for the actual service and for the celebration here tonight. Of course, like to Mr. Finn and the members of the management team, okay, always very supportive of me in my role as chaplain and of the Wish Stella. you know, best of luck with her retirement. She will be missed in the school. The members of the RE department, okay, some of whom are here tonight, who all was very supportive of me throughout the year. I'd like to thank the people who have been so instrumental in creating such a lovely atmosphere in school, doing the quad. We have various people who are out there, you know, over days doing things, and today, so the people who were instrumental in the quad, that was Mr. Bolton, Roisin Dempsey, we had David Neary, Eileen Tumulty, all out there today. And I want to mention one person in particular, Miss Theresa Kenny. She's done so much over the past 2 weeks to prepare the quad for tonight's celebrations. And you might have heard Mr. Finn say earlier on that she was out power washing, and she was out power washing. I'm not sure how many hours, perhaps she can tell me, how many hours she spent out there with various helpers, particularly Kate Moran was one of the ones. Okay. So we'd like to thank Theresa. And Theresa, like myself, is nearer the end of her career than the beginning of it. And, you know, it's hard work, and I have to say, I really admire Theresa for doing that, for seeing that something needed to be done and doing it. So well done to Theresa. And I'd like to ask Ava and Remy to come up and just present Theresa with a little token of the school's gratitude. Service here tonight. I want to thank Keenan Fitzpatrick, who's back there. He is streaming this whole thing for us. Okay, so thank you very much, Keenan. And of course, to everybody who took part in the service, to the readers, the musicians, and all the different participants. It's not easy getting up here to speak in front of a huge crowd. I'm not even sure how many people are here, but it's certainly more than the 850 chairs we put out earlier today. So, and a particular word of gratitude to our first-year students, to Katie and to Quiva. Okay, you have great futures ahead of you here in the school, girls. Well done. And of course, to our musicians and our choirs, aren't they wonderful? Yeah. And I want to thank Miss Dempsey and Miss Clancy, who are here tonight, and all, of course, the other members of the music department. We are so gifted, you know, so many gifted people in our school, okay, in the music department. Well, particularly for Miss Dempsey and Miss Clancy here tonight, and I would like to thank them for all the wonderful music, not just for this tonight, okay, but throughout the year, and for many, many school events. So I'd like to ask the two girls, if you would mind. Just a little token. Just a little token of appreciation for all your hard work. And I know that your students love working with you and they find you inspiring. And thank you very much. And to you parents who have produced such wonderful young people, who we are proud to say are graduating from our school, I would like to extend a special thanks for your continuing and unwavering support for all of us here in the school. And finally, I would like to thank the young people who are graduating. You have developed into fine young people, full of talent, good humour, humanity and goodness. These qualities will stand you in good stead when you move on to the next exciting chapter of your lives. Your resilience has seen you through tough times over the past number of years, and that will continue to do so. Thank you for allowing me to journey with you, for allowing me into your lives. It has been a privilege. I always feel the bonds forged in adversity are strong and long-lasting. You will be missed from the school. I will certainly miss you. Mr. Chats and the good-natured crack in the quad. particularly the antics of the six-year boys, the lads in the corner, and the much more mature and cooler girls looking on with amusement and horror. I'll miss seeing wheelbarrows, microwaves, sinks, basketball nets on anything but a bag day. I will miss the chats over a cup of tea, okay, about random things, the casual dropping in, being invited into the music class to hear, going into the art class to see your, see all of that. And thank you also for making my year, for allowing me to score the winning goal in the first ever. The first ever, hopefully annual, female staff versus student game, which was far more skillful than the boys' game, which was on show last Monday. What do you think, girls? Wasn't it? Yeah, far more skillful. So please stay in touch. Nowadays it's easy with social media. You continue to be part of our extended family here in Gorey Community School. I will see you around for the exams, and of course we wish you the best of luck. And finally, we know you're heading out tonight. We want you to take care of each other. Do not let anyone be on their own. Stay in your groups, stay safe. Everyone in this gym here tonight cares about you. We want you to be safe. Make good decisions so that it is an enjoyable and memorable night for the right reasons. Congratulations on your graduation. I just have one announcement. Just at the end, can I ask the six-year students just to stay in your places? Okay, just to get... I know, yeah, I know. My heart bleeds for you, And the parents' refreshments are being served in the quad by the Parents' Association, and we thank them for that. So if the parents want to head out and enjoy the refreshments, and the six-year student, we're going to ask you just to stay and collect your mementos for tonight. Okay? And we finish with our choir. So, we have one more song, after the final song. Thank you. Okay, you can just take your places. After the final song. Thank you. Thank you.
for your mother, fast for your father.